gentlemen, my favorite. Round of applause. Big round of applause. Please pick up the microphone.
Thank you for thanking me.
Where is Emmanuella?
Emmanuella has to be in school. She's in Nigeria.
Would she have loved to come?
Yes.
Did she have any message for the people that you were coming to see?
And she said she tell the people of Accra that she loves Ghana.
Yeah.
And she wants to come to Ghana next year.
Whoa.
So next year, I'm going to do a tour in Ghana.
Oh, I see. All right, let's give a round of applause for that if you want to see that. Okay. Does anyone have a question? Who'd want to ask Archangel the first question? You? You? Okay.
I want you to ask, what would be your best advice to someone who is just starting by YouTube channel?
Best advice to someone who is just starting a YouTube channel?
Don't stop. You're just starting, don't stop.
Sure.
Is that all?
And that is the best thing.
Don't stop.
Uh-huh. Don't stop. Okay. From starting now, you have owned one channel and you have become a YouTuber. You're starting that starts it. Don't stop.
So that's it. If you are starting, don't stop. So, how did you start? You were a comedian, right? So getting into the YouTube space, you know, with your craft and all that, how did it all begin?
Okay, see, one mistake that people are making is that you're calling me comedian.
Oh, you're not? My bad.
A person is funny, it doesn't mean that the person is comedian.
A lot of your videos are funny.
Yes.
But my bad.
No. I mean, I don't blame, that's the perception that I give. You know, but in recent, I am just one person that is creating content because a lot of people don't know. I own other channels, you know, moving on. I own other channels that are not even doing comedy. They are doing dramas, they are doing travel, and doing other things. So it's content creation that I do. Okay, how I started? I like film making. In fact, I like pictures. I like anything. I like anything that you, okay, let me give you one story. I used to work in a cyber cafe back in 2006. And then Anna stumbled onto Window Movie Maker. You guys know that thing, right?
Yeah.
So Anna carried, and I said, wow, okay, this is what they used to make movies, eh? I carried a clip and I started fiddling with the thing. And I was able to edit something and it came out very well. I was like, a filmmaker! That was how I could. Yes! I did my first edit. I edited one music. I changed the music. I turned the music upside down. In fact, I met, if the guy had seen that, the guy was slapping me. Turned the music upside down. But I liked it because, and I knew that I could make a story, it's storytelling. I could tell the story the way I want it with the tools. So I found out that I want to send out messages. I can edit message the way I want people to perceive it and send out. And it's what they watch that they believe. So all the positive messages I want to send out of Africa and my neighborhood, especially my neighborhood at that time, I knew I could use editing and storytelling to, you know, change narrative. That was how I started.
So that's how you started?
Yes.
So it's a passion that you had?
Yes.
Or it's a passion that you had, I'm just saying. Did you go to any school to study for this kind of thing? Or just from the movie maker, that Windows movie maker, you entered your first video and you just sort of started from there?
Well, I started from there, sort of. Then, and I found out that, okay, and I went to school, you know, I got admission and went to school. But I was studying medicine. It was not working for me.
You wanted to be a doctor?
It was not working for me. You know how your parents will tell you that you have to go to school, study medicine, and then every time your mother is passing on the way, they say, Mama, doctor. She's like, yeah, that's what she wanted.
And did you want to be a doctor? or it was something?
I didn't know what I wanted. I knew that I had to go to school and study something, but I wanted to make films, you know. So fortunately for me, I got troubles with paying my school fees, and there was nothing my parents could do about it. So I left school, and I said, okay, you know what? Let me just even go and learn something. I was working as a photographer in school. I was saving up, but I wanted my parents to pay school fees. But since they did not pay the school fees, I took the money that I saved and used it to travel to buy the photography and editing. And so I said, you know, if you guys cannot pay my school fees, I have to drop out now. And they say, yes, so no, I'll just wait. Like, thank you, Jesus. So when I started, learned photography, learned editing, and then I came back and started working in Hollywood. But that wasn't what I wanted. I wanted to be able to, it's about storytelling. I wanted to tell my own stories. I wanted to, you know, and then I found out, okay, yeah, I can now just be out of job, be jobless, be unemployed, and start something that I can do.
So with YouTube, at what point did YouTube come in? You decide to start putting your content on YouTube, so you create a page and start putting your content there. Apart from, of course, all the other social media handles that are there, YouTube, though in particular, how did that come in?
Okay, I started with WhatsApp. In fact, I did not start with WhatsApp, I started with one-on-one. I don't know if it happened in Ghana. There was a time when you have these guys with computer on the street that will come and download music and put it on their phones.
We had
it in Nigeria too. So I would go and meet them, give them 20 naira, and tell them anybody that come here, when you finish teaching music, can you use my video and put it in the person's phone? You know, that was how I started. And I would meet somebody, have you watched my video? You say, who are you? I say, wait, let me show you. You know, one-on-one, and then I started using WhatsApp to share the videos. So it was crazy. Like, I remember there was a time that I'll come into this conference and I'll be introducing myself to everybody. My name is Mark. I do videos. Let me have your number. I'll send it to you. So I had contacts. At the time, I was sending videos to 17,000 people on my phone.
Whoa.
Yeah, 17,000 people on my phone. In fact, somebody discovered it and then told somebody about it, and a telecom company called me and said, "Please have your, let's buy your contact." I said, "No, sell it. What are you buying it for?" You know. So I was able to share it, and now in 2013, I now found out, okay, I could go beyond sharing to Nigerians. I can start sharing to people who watch, because at that time Nigerians didn't watch YouTube. Like, there was no data to watch YouTube. So I now put it on YouTube and knew that other people from other countries would find it. I watched YouTube tutorials, how people are making videos and how they're sharing them. So I followed some steps and I was able to get a few people to watch, and then started putting it on there.
So what's the best content to you create?
This is not my thesis. When Emmanuella came on board.
This is not my real face.
Yes.
How did that work come? Where did you find Emmanuella to bring her on board, you know, to start creating those videos with her? Because those videos are not one of the most viral, most watched content, you know, on YouTube and other social media platforms. So how did that happen? There's water, please.
Okay.
Yes, it is for you.
So, thank you. So, as a YouTuber, just like every YouTuber has experienced, there are times that you will make content and you will not get views. But the journey is to discover your niche, discover your audience. So, in that race, you will try a lot of things and know what works best for you. So I tried a lot of things. In fact, I made videos, made long videos, made short videos, and I found out that I tried with Emmanuella because I needed children content, right? Because there was children were consuming, there was no content that children were consuming. And I said, okay, you know what? I'm making skits with children. Maybe this week I do with children, next week I do with, you know, my female adult. I found out. At the time, I used to have children who would come to the house, their parents would bring them to the house to come and learn dancing and learn things. And, you know, because people in my area believe that I could teach anything in entertainment because they always saw me with camera. So, Manuela came for holidays in my house. Manuela is my distant cousin. She came for holidays in my house and she was part of the children. I was always, you know, saying, you know, sit down, let us add drama and all that. Then I gave her the role. She played it very well. We tested it out. It took us like 1 whole day to shoot a 1 minute and 26 seconds video. We were able to get it. And that video just went fun.
Just went bad.
I say, eh.
So instead of using that one, I said, let me use the child again. I tried again. The boom went,
joy!
I'm wasting my time.
This is it.
So that was how the Manuela journey started.
Okay. So, of course, you work closely with Emmanuela. You describe her as your distant cousin. What kind of person do you see? Pretty sure a lot of people like this, and you know. And what is it like to work with them?
Ella is a very lovable person. Very lovable child. But if you stay around him, Ella, you just know that this life, nothing there inside him. Everything is a joke to her. Like, nothing is serious. Ella told me recently that the only thing that is serious in this life is death, too. You know? Like she's a very lovable kid. Very lovable kid. Some of the people have said around her. One day she's very lovable. That's the only one I can remember. English. I don't know how to speak English.
So at this point, what does it feel like to be described or to be the biggest or largest content creator when it comes to YouTube on the app? What is that feeling like?
It just makes you know that you have responsibility. You know, you have responsibility. You can't just be. The aim is not to be the biggest. The aim is to have focus on Africa. We have a lot, like, we all here, we are better than any other continent. If you ask me, I've made my research. And the aim is to bring whatever it is that these platforms are giving to other people, to bring it down here. You know, so it's responsibility, big responsibility. So I think right at this point, I'm trying to get bigger content creators to saturate the African market so that the responsibility will reduce.
And this is a great platform to do that. There are a lot of people here who are content creators themselves. So like I've asked every panelist who has sat here, what is that one thing that you've learned throughout your journey to this point that can tell them to hold on to make sure that they become as successful as you? You already said that.
Give me Mike. Okay. Don't stop. Just be consistent. A lot of things come like what they say. You have a lot of haters. They are not haters per se. They are motivators. And don't let them distract you. A lot of people will tell you, come on, get away, you are not funny. I hate this video. This video, I just wasted my data in this journey. But those same people, if you want to take notes, study one particular fan. Every time you upload a video, look for that fan. You find out that one day, that same fan, so wow, this is the greatest video I've ever watched. That same fan that's telling you, remove this thing from the internet. That same person is going to tell you. So it's not like addiction. It's culture. It's internet culture. It's bullying. And people find it funny doing it. So don't let it deter you. You know, and then just know that content is king in this business. Another thing is, take your content creation, English,
serious?
Take it serious. Take it as a business, because it won't be nice that you're a content creator and at the end of the day you end up a content creator. You should be a business person who employs. The aim is to get people employed. You're just like a CEO of a business. That way, I think you are then success. Then from the beginning, first, like what they say, it is not about fame. First, plan out your business. Ask yourself, what do I want to achieve with this channel? What exactly do I want to achieve? Some people, you have a side business that you want to use the YouTube channel or the content you're creating to promote. Some people, you want to send messages out, you want to change the narrative of Africa, you want to have people travel. You need to know what you want to achieve. Then you ask yourself, why? And then write it down. So that when you start employing people, they are going to have the same culture. They will know what this company, that now you've come from a company to a brand, from a brand to a company, they will know what the company stands for. So that, you know, you will not lose the vision along the way.
Do you have any regrets trying this plan?
The same regret that he has. Why did I not start in 2006? At that time, I did that now, I just say, yeah, YouTube! I regret not starting again. I knew that was YouTube. It was Vimeo, you go. I didn't understand the thing. I was like, so you want to put something. Until I just said, you know what, let me even be able to send this thing to you. I wish I had sent it to out. But I mean, I just started earlier. He knew. I'm sure we understand that. I'm not having to speak English.
So it comes back to what he said first. Don't stop, right? If you want to start, start now. So let's play a game. Let's play a game now.
We want to but I don't know how to dance.
But are we ready to play the game? We want to play the game. Yeah, let's play the game. For them.
Truth.
Truth. What is your biggest fear as a YouTuber?
My biggest fear as a YouTuber is to wake up one day and I can't pay the people that I employ. You know, and that is not being able to reach out to people. And when you don't reach out, you don't get paid. When you're not able to put your voice out, you don't get paid. When you can't write story, you don't get paid. And then it means that the people who you are responsible for, you feel them.
Is it a difficult thing to do with all the content that you create, putting it out there, it's monetized, getting the income in, paying all the people that you need to pay, those who work with you? Is it difficult?
If I want to lie to you now, tell you it's not difficult. But I will not lie to you, it's difficult. Every trade is difficult. But then when you start enjoying it, it becomes a job, like it becomes your work. You wake up in the morning and know that this is what you have to do, and that's why you need to stay healthy. No matter what you're doing, let your health be one priority in your life, because the day you fall sick for 1 week, everybody will say, where is that guy? Stop posting again, let me get to the next person. The market is saturated, so you don't want that to happen. So it's always, you cannot say you will not be sick, but you have to try to stay healthy.
All right, truth or dare once more.
True to
truth day. Do we want truth or do we want dare?
Okay. I don't have to dance though.
Let's go to parliament. We'll do what the speaker does. All in favor say aye, all in favor say no. All in favor of truth say aye. All in favor of dare say no. The no's have it. I can't do it. You'll do it there.
Okay.
Are you ready? Don't worry, it doesn't involve dancing.
Ah.
We want you to do something crazy, something radical. You have Instagram?
Yes.
On your phone. Go on Instagram live right now.
Okay.
And start a feud with another YouTuber or one of the beginning photos. Just go on Instagram live right now. Call out somebody.
Call out somebody.
Call out somebody. This is
the best.
Call out somebody.
Very simple.
Yes.
I'm going to
start to the person left right side.